proved in our own jurisprudence. This is at page 61 of this paper book that I've placed before your lordships. And the question here was whether a proviso, what is the function of a proviso? Whether it is always...
Sorry, which case are you referring to?
This is the case is titled The Commissioner of Stamp Duties versus Allen Cavey Atwill. And this is 1973 Appeal Cases 558 Privy Council. And this has been noted with approval in 2017 PTD page 1. I've placed that judgment here as well. Now kindly see on the question of what a proviso does. This matter had come to the Privy Council from Australia, where the High Court had taken the view that a proviso can only restrict what precedes it and do nothing more. And I read at page 63. Their lordships are not able to agree with this conclusion. While in many cases, that is the function of a proviso. It is the substance and content of the enactment, not its form, which has to be considered, and that which is expressed to be a proviso may itself add to and not merely limit or qualify that which precedes it. Then I skip the next paragraph. I go down to the paragraph thereafter. In my view, that is not the case here, and as Lord Herschel pointed out in the same case, of course a proviso may be used to guide you in the selection of one or other of two possible constructions of the words to be found in the enactment and show when there is doubt about its scope, when it may reasonably admit of doubt as to its having the scope or that which is the proper view to take of it. My lords, that is precisely the method of construction which in my view is applicable in the present case. I will add that the words beginning, provided that, are in my opinion additional and explanatory words necessary for the purpose of giving a more definite meaning to the preceding words, that is of removing doubt as to its scope, and they might easily have been incorporated in the earlier part of the section at the risk of making it rather more cumbrous than it is. We are not dealing here with a true proviso, or at any rate, not with such a proviso as this House was considering in the case cited. It cannot, I think, be disputed that in construing a section of an Act of Parliament, it is constantly necessary to explain the meaning of the words by an examination of the purport and effect of other sections in the same Act. This principle is equally applicable in the case of different parts of a single section, and nonetheless that the latter part is introduced by the words provided that or like words. There can, I think, be no doubt that the view expressed in Kent's commentaries on American law is correct. The true principle undoubtedly is that the sound interpretation and meaning of the statute on a view of the enacting clause, saving clause and proviso taken and construed together is to prevail. And this goes on in the next page, just one line at page 64, the third line from the top. But in the present case, not only is the first part of the section deficient in express definition, but the second part is complementary and necessary in order to ascertain the full intention of the legislature. Now let me pause here.
Please pause. Now here, this is the Constitution of Pakistan.
Yes.
If I have to refer to the Privy Council to understand it, then it fails its purpose. ये लोगों के लिए बनाया गया आइन, ये लोगों के मुंतखब लोगों ने बनाया है आइन, अब हमें प्रिवी काउंसिल की इंटरप्रिटेशन की कोई जरूरत नहीं है जब चीज वाजे हो.
But this is the only...
अब आप इसमें अगर नहीं कोई आदमी नहीं समझ सकता है, इसीलिए आइन को कोई वक्त आप नहीं दे रहे हैं, क्योंकि आइन को आम किताब है, कोई भी पढ़ के उसको समझ सकता है, कोई मुश्किल काम नहीं है इसमें. अब आप जाएं कि नहीं ये इंटरप्रिटेशन के लिए मुझे प्रिवी काउंसिल जाना होगा और फिर सिंध हाई कोर्ट के पास जाना होगा, क्योंकि सिर्फ और सिर्फ वो अंग्रेज हमें समझा सकेगा. अच्छा, कि हमने नहीं, जो अपने लिए चीज किताब जरा सुन दे, आप सुन ही नहीं रहे, बार बार इशारे कर रहे हैं. अब आप देख, हमने आपको बिल्कुल सुन लिया ना आराम से, बीच में बोला मैं कोई
नहीं सर, मैं
तो जरा तहमुल से करें ना
मुझे.
नहीं तो ये जरा ये देखिए, आइन कोई अहमियत है इसकी, कोई आदमी आता है कोई आ जाता है बाहर से चल के आ जाता है, उस पर जी उसका मतलब ये, तो चार जजेस को जमा करके उनको बिठा दें, उसका मतलब ये, भाई ये मात्र नहीं, जो आइन जो वाजे है उस पे अमल कर रहे हैं. हमें प्रिवी काउंसिल को छोड़ दीजिए.
ठीक हो गया सर, अब आप देखिए, वी मूव अवे फ्रॉम द प्रिवी काउंसिल.
ये जो सीधा साधा आइन है, इसमें
सीधा साधा आइन ही मैं अर्ज कर रहा हूँ. देयरफॉर माय सबमिशन इज दैट व्हेन वी रीड द टू पार्ट्स ऑफ clause D and E together, the main body and the proviso, what comes out is as follows. There is a constitutional principle, a salient feature. The democracy, representative form of government are integral to the constitution. That is the principle. And the constitution here has an envisaged outcome, which is a representative national assembly. So we start with the principle of democracy and representative form of government and the legislature being representative. And the outcome is the National Assembly. In between, there is a machinery provision. The machinery provision in Article 51 is the principle of proportional representation. Now, partly, this is a method of election. It calls it Article 51, 6D, says that this is how women will be elected to the reserved seats. This is how non-Muslims will be elected to the reserved seats. So this is an election which is going on. And a mechanism is given. Now, the question, therefore, is when we take this in its entirety, the two parts of both clauses D and E, we are to uphold the democratic principle, the representativeness principle, which is at the heart of the Constitution, and ensure that the National Assembly that emerges on account of these two methods of election, the general election for the direct election for the general seats, and the proportional representation election for the reserved seats, both reflect the will of the people. That is what my Lord Justice Manila has been alluding to, that what is at play here is the will of the people. Now, this is the higher principle that this...
If the will of the people ka aap argument kare hain, to phir to proportional representation hona hi nahi chahiye. Sidha sada unko candidate bana dein.
I mean,
ye kya baat hai, will of the people. Aap ye lafz to jumle to achhe istamal kar rahe hain, magar jo system diya hua aayin mein, dekhiye, woh baar baar main usi mein aa raha hoon.
Aap mujhe arz karne dein. An election is reflects the will of the people.
Ya to koi points likhe hain to main likhun.
Ye point
aap agar falsafe ki baat kar rahe hain, woh main nahi likhunga. Main isliye आपको बार बार आईन पे ला रहा हूं कि आईन पे फोकस करें।
आईन ही मैं पढ़ रहा हूं, मैं अर्ज ये कर रहा हूं कि इस क्लॉज को जब आप पढ़ेंगे 51, 6D को
पढ़ लिया, विल ऑफ द पीपल को लेते हैं, लर्निंग काउंसिल विल ऑफ द पीपल। अब ये बताएं, जब विल ऑफ द पीपल ने तो वोट दिया
इंडिपेंडेंट
उनने पीटीआई के कैंडिडेट्स को दिया,
जी ठीक,
अब वो हाउ हु डिसाइडेड दैट दे विल जॉइन, इज देयर अ मैकेनिज्म, इज इट अलाउड इन योर पार्टी, वाज एनी प्रोसेस फॉलोड बाय द पार्टी टू से ओके, क्योंकि देखें जब आप वोट लेने गए उस वोटर को क्या ये था कि आपने ज्वाइन करना है एससीसी,
जी मैं अर्ज करूं सर, अब आप एक
राजा साहब
जी
सच कह दीजिएगा, कोई फर्क नहीं है,
बिल्कुल सच कहूंगा
सुप्रीम को
ना, वो माय लॉर्ड
सेज, आई डोंट नो व्हाई एवरीवन इज सो हेजिटेंट टू सप्रेस द ट्रूथ।
सर हुआ यूं कि जब हमें डिक्लेयर कर दिया इलेक्शन कमीशन ने कि हम इंडिपेंडेंट हैं, so our symbols were those of independence, there are two lists of symbols, one were symbols
of aapki ek party constitution hai na ji,
ji
us constitution mein procedure hoga ki agar koi emergency ho to ye party decision le ja sakti hai, hum ye kar sakte hain, lekin aap you can't ye nahi keh sakte ki ji there were three senior lawyers who got together and they decided, it's a political party, they have a constitution, aap hame,
so this is a very unexpected situation, nobody